Hello, and welcome to the Bronx. Thank you for joining us. I'm thrilled to be presenting composer Frank Warren and his piece Trio for violin, cello, and piano. We hope you enjoy it.
When I was young, the Boston Pops used to come around to the local schools. And so when I heard they were performing at the school in my neighborhood, which was the summer before I started first grade, so I would have been five. So I went up to listen to the Boston Pops, and the conductor turned around and said, "I'm going to play a piece you all know, but you probably don't know where it comes from." And as soon as he said that, in the back of my mind, I said, "He's going to play the theme from The Lone Ranger." And sure enough, he turns around and starts playing William Tell Overture. Of course, I didn't know it was the William Tell Overture until he explained it to the audience. But when the whole concert, you know, I got all excited with the sound of the orchestra and everything. And when the whole concert was over, I remember standing up, and, you know, when you're 5 years old, everyone else is so much taller. And it was like the Red Sea parting, and a light bulb went up over my head that said, when I grow up, I want to be a composer. I like to think that anything that we hear, even if it doesn't influence us, it will be something that we respond to. So I'd like to think that any music I've heard, from early chant to contemporary music, is something, if I find that there's something inspirational about it, it will eventually find a way into something that I'm writing somehow, even if it is reshaped to fit my own expression. I'd have to go with some people that are probably on everyone else's list: Bach for the counterpoint, Beethoven for form and expression. I choose Schoenberg because of the depth of his work. I also like Satie very much because he has a way of expressing lightness with intelligence. And as a post-romantic, of course, I have to go with Vaughan Williams just to keep that thread alive. Well, the main difference is I'm 20 years older. And I think that 20 years ago, any idea that popped into my head went onto a list of pieces that I wanted to write. And, the list just got longer and longer, and the list is still there, and not every piece that got added onto the list got written. But I felt like any idea I had was a challenge, and I needed to meet that challenge, and I needed to prove something. I wasn't sure what it was. Perhaps I just needed to prove that, yes, I actually am a composer. I think the biggest difference now, 20 years later, is that I still like a challenge anytime I start a new piece, because that's where the excitement is. That's what makes it worthwhile. But I'm more selective. You know, I won't do any idea that pops into my head. I'll think about which projects I want to do and plan them carefully and you know, not overwhelm myself with a list of new works to do. There's the pre-composition stage where I work on motives and scales and try to figure out which ideas are going to develop into the piece that I want to write, and which are going to let the ideas carry through for the whole piece. And so, you know, there's a lot of work in the pre-composition stage. And then when I am satisfied with the work I've done there, I let it set in my subconscious for a while. And when I feel that I'm ready to start writing, I kind of get a signal that says, okay, start writing, and I start writing, and the writing generally will work pretty quickly. And then I'll just write from beginning pretty much to end, taking breaks in between when I need to rest. And then at the end, I'll spend a lot of time editing, correcting whatever things I feel need to be strengthened, or finding mistakes that need to be fixed. But I think the most rewarding stage is when I think a piece is finished and then I finally get to work with the performers, and then the performers give me the goods and say, you know, why don't we try this? Why don't we try that? And, you know, I really trust performers because of the hard work that they put into, you know, becoming who they are. And so I give value to whatever suggestions I'm given. And, you know, you folks made a lot of great suggestions for my trio, so I think it's a good system. And it seems to work for me. I've written some pieces in an afternoon, and I have some pieces that I've been working on for 30 years and are still not finished. For example, on the piano trio, each movement did not take very long to write, but I took a little time between each movement. And of course, since I used basically the same material for each movement, that made it a little easier. I think what takes the most time in writing a piece is editing afterwards. So the actual writing itself, you know, now that I've been doing it for a long time, does not take long. It's the preparation and the finishing up work afterwards that takes a long time. When I first started, I used to sit at the piano and plunk out notes because I'm not a piano player. And after I'd been plunking notes for a while, it occurred to me that if I rely on the piano to do my composing, then my my composing will probably never get any better than my piano playing. So that's when I started walking out into the woods. And, you know, I was inspired by that painting by whoever it is that's supposed to be Beethoven writing the Sixth Symphony, you know, on the, sitting next to the brook, leaning against a tree. And so that's pretty much what I did. And there were a bunch of guys at Berkeley that all practiced in the same area at the same time. And I'd bring in these pieces that they were always happy to play through them for me. And, you know, they'd tell me what wrong notes I was writing and what I was doing wrong for their particular instrument. And, you know, it was a great way to learn. So, but yes, I do everything out of my head. I rely on the nerve impulses that go from my brain to my hand. When I was a student, I made a list of, you know, how most people have a bucket list. My bucket list was compositions I write before my day is over. And of course, the piano trio was on that list. So the list was written long before I even got around to writing this particular piece. So if we want to start at when I wrote Piano Trio on that list, it was a very long time. But if we start with, okay, it's time for me to do this piece, what am I going to do? It was probably, I would say, a year and a half, maybe a little longer to complete the piece. The Ravel Trio, and since it's a 12-tone piece, just 12-tone music in general, and even though I don't use 12-tone, the 12-tone technique as a rule, I very rarely use it. I thought it would be an interesting way for me to approach this piece.
Thank you. Thank you.